subscribe to our channel and press the bell button for latest educational videos.
Welcome to Classic YouTube channel. Myself, Kirti Gowda K, Faculty for International Relations, Classic IAS Study Circle, Dharwad. So, if you are preparing from PC, from Police Constable to DC for UPSC, the international relations assumes lot of importance. So, for one line answer, the hot topics in the international arena should be considered, and for UPSC and KPSC, for KAS and IAS, this is very important. This will appear even in mains. Now, let me study about the hot topic that is happening between India and China, in the India-China border. That is the Galwan clashes. The Galwan clashes between India and China. Why are there frequent clashes between India and China? Though we have a LAC, meaning line of actual control, that demarcates the Indian administered territory and the Chinese administered territory, still we see repeated incursions from both the sides. Why so? To understand this, we have to understand the demarcation. The demarcation, just because there is ambiguity in the perception of LAC. There is ambiguity in the perception of LAC. The Chinese perception of LAC is different from the India's perception of LAC. So let me tell you how the borders are demarcated or divided. So just let me go through the map. If you observe the Indo-China map here, the border, the 3,400 odd kilometer border, can be divided into three sectors, that is the western sector, the mid sector and the eastern sector. So it's a 3,400 odd kilometer boundary. So if you look here, in the western sector comes the Ladakh region, in the western sector comes the Ladakh region here. So in the middle section is the Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. In the Himachal Pradesh is the Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand. So in the eastern sector, in the eastern sector comes Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim. In the eastern sector it comes Arunachal Pradesh and Sikkim. If we want to go to the source of all this, you have to understand Mao Zedong of China, who was responsible for the Cultural Revolution in China. What was the strategy of Mao Zedong? Mao Zedong's strategy of China was the what is called the hand, palm and finger strategy. The hand, palm and finger strategy. So to understand the hand, palm and finger strategy of Mao, of China, let me go to the whiteboard to explain you in detail. So according to Mao, the hand, the palm, the fingers. So hand according to Mao is nothing but the China. China is the hand according to Mao. The palm is nothing but Tibet. And the fingers are in the western sector of the border, as I explained, there are divided into three sectors, that is western sector, mid sector and eastern sector. In the western sector, the finger is Uttarakhand, UK, Uttarakhand, then comes Nepal, Bhutan, Sikkim, and the last one, the Arunachal Pradesh. Now you know the fingers: Uttarakhand, Nepal, Bhutan, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. You know how China lays claim to the Arunachal Pradesh and it also lays claim to the Uttarakhand. Now you understand the hand, palm, fingers strategy of China. China's strategy when it comes to the border disputes is nibble and negotiate. It infiltrates an inch and claims a mile. So it erupts an dispute for an inch, but later on when the negotiation takes place, it claims miles together. That is the strategy. So with hand, palm, finger strategy of China, now you know why there are repeated border incursions in the Indo-China border. So this is all about the Chinese perception. The Chinese, this is the LAC. So I said about the ambiguity in the perception of LAC. So what is the ambiguity? What is the difference of opinion between India and China for the LAC? As you see, LAC runs through here. In the western sector, it runs through here. This is what is known as the Aksai Chin region. The Aksai Chin region. What is the significance of this Aksai Chin region? So the significance is after the 1962 war. If you turn the history pages and look over it, you can see the 1962 Indo-China war. In this war, what happened? China illegally occupied a part of the erstwhile Jammu and Kashmir, claimed by India. But this part, this section of the Aksai Chin has been under Chinese occupation since 1962. And here lies the, in the Trijunction area lies the Siachen Glacier. And this part in particular, this was illegally gifted by Park to China. The name of this is called the Shaksgam Valley. So now we know the Aksai Chin has been under Chinese occupation since the 1962 war. So why Galwan clashed then? So why Galwan clash? It's because of the ambiguity in the perception of LAC. Now you are able to understand the hand, palm and finger strategy of Mao and the division of LAC and the division of LAC. Like LOC, the line of control that exists between India and Pakistan, where there is mutual understanding and mutual respect for LOC, though there are repeated infiltrations, but LAC is not properly demarcated. LAC is not properly demarcated, meaning, so the China, according to China, 2000 kilometer stretch is what the LAC is. 2000 kilometer is the stretch what LAC is. But according to India, it is 3490 kilometers. Why? Because Chinese fingers, if you remember the hand, palm and finger strategy, the Chinese finger, Arunachal Pradesh is a Chinese finger, the Sikkim is a Chinese finger, and the Ladakh, the Union Territory of Ladakh is also a Chinese finger. So eliminating all these fingers, what remains is the Chinese perception of LAC. And also, if you see the LAC here, the Aksai Chin region lies in the Tibetan Autonomous Region. That means it belongs to China and administered by China right now. So what happened here? Why this demarcation? Because of the 1962 Indo-China War. So where did the clashes take place? The clashes took place in three places along this western sector, also known as subsector north. So what do you mean by it then? The subsector north, where did the incursion or the clashes between India and China took place? It took place along the western sector in the Ladakh region, where the LAC is demarcated. So the places in consideration are the Pangong So Lake, very important lake, the Pangong So Lake, and its geographical location should be known for the examination viewpoint. Okay, so the Galwan Valley, where the present this one is taking place, and a lot of casualties has been reported from both the sides, and the hot spring area. So okay, these are the three points of clashes. So in 1962, why did India and China go for the war? The major flashpoint in that year was the incident in Galwan. So the incident in Galwan in 1962 was the major flashpoint that led to the brief war of 1962, which led to the illegal occupation of Aksai Chin by China. So these are the three places of consideration. So why the clashes in Galwan, to be precise, to be exact, why did China clash with India in the Galwan area? So if you look at this dotted line, this is nothing but the LAC, the demarcation between India and China. So Aksai Chin has been occupied by China. It's under Chinese occupation, but claimed by India. India lays claim to this part, but China is administering it right now. So if you see here in the Chushul district, if the name Chushul springs up, you have to know the recent glacier outburst in the Uttarakhand. It's also a potential question for your competitive examinations. How the Nanda Devi glacier broke out in the Ladakh region and how it caused the flash floods in Rishi Ganga and Dhauli Ganga rivers. It's very important for examinations. You have to keep note of the current affairs. Okay. So here lies the Galwan Valley, exactly where on the line of LAC or just beside the line of LAC. Even hot springs is in that region, it concurs with the line of actual control, even Pangong So Lake. Pangong So Lake is not just important strategically, but it's also an resource rich lake. Whoever lays claim to the Pangong So can utilize the blue water economy. That means fisheries, mineral explorations, navigation, etc., etc. So I have said there is an ambiguity in the line of perception, ambiguity in perception. So what is the Chinese perception here? So what was the main trigger why the India and China clashed in this region? So the main trigger was a building of a road by the Indian side. What was the road? The road was DSDBO. The road was DSDBO. So what does DSDBO stand for? DSDBO stand for Darbuk Shok. Darbuk Shok, Daulat Beg Woldi. So the construction of DSDBO road by the Indian authorities, rightfully in the Indian side of LAC, this angered China. So the name of the road is DSDBO, Darbuk Shok, Daulat Beg Woldi Road. Shok is the name of the river that flows in UK or Uttarakhand. Okay. So why did this anger China? What is the importance of DSDBO? DSDBO, the Darbuk Shok, Daulat Beg Woldi. In the Daulat Beg Woldi, the name of the place, there exists an airstrip. There exists an Indian airstrip. So the military mobilization from the Indian side will be very easy in case of any adverse event, in case of Chinese aggression or transgressing the border. This airstrip will be helpful in mobilizing the forces faster, at a faster phase. So from 1962, China is opposed to any border construction in the Indian side. Even if it is within the boundary of India, China is opposed to Indian construction or Indian development of road and other infrastructures that may aid military to thwart any misadventure steps by China. So it is opposed to any construction in the Indian side. So it opposed this construction of the feeder road. It is a feeder road. So what do you mean by feeder? Feeder means there will be a main road to connect this. There will be a road that joins in the midway or in somewhere along it. So this is the feeder. So this is the feeder. So the feeder road is being constructed. Why? Why? Because to meet the airstrip, to go to the airstrip, this road has been constructed. So China opposed it. Why? Because I have just explained it. So you see in the map, this is the flow of the Shok River. This is where the Shok River flows. Okay. So this is the Shok River. So this is the DSDBO road. DSDBO road. Here comes the Galwan River. Where is the origin of the Galwan River? Galwan River originates in the Aksai Chin region that's been administered or controlled by China right now. It originates in the Aksai Chin region and flows through Ladakh. And there is it meets the Shok River. And this is the point of confluence. It is where the Galwan River meets the Shok River. This is the point of confluence. So according to the Indian perception of LAC, the LAC lies in the confluence of the Galwan and Shok River. If you observe the DSDBO road, it's along the ridge or the bank of Shok River. So if you see, according to the Indian perception of LAC, it lies well within the LAC. But China is opposed to road construction anywhere along the border area. So the difference of opinion erupted, and the China, after the June 5th clash of Galwan, the China lays claim that the LAC, the Chinese LAC, lies beyond the point of confluence of Galwan River and the Shok River. So this is the dispute when China unilaterally changed the status quo. Indian government was angered and it issued the statement as to this is well within the boundary of India and we will not halt the construction. Presently the construction is going on and it gives advanced military capabilities to India to mobilize its troops faster. Got it? So what might be the other reasons for it then? What might be the other reasons? The one other reason is, if you understand the hand, palm, finger strategy of Mao or of China, Ladakh is also a finger of China. That means China lays claims to the Ladakh region. So with the abrogation of Article 370, what it did? It converted the state of Jammu and Kashmir to a union territory, and also the Ladakh was declared as an union territory. And by declaring it a union territory, what it will do? It will give sweeping powers. The sweeping powers will be given to the central government. So the policy decision, the policy and the decision making will be lot more quicker. So this also angered China. And due to the recent pandemic, the COVID-19 pandemic, China was in the bad books of international community. So it wanted to divert the attention somewhere else. So that may be also given as the reason why China clashed with India in the Galwan area. Even though the DSDBO, construction of DSDBO road was well within the perception of Indian LAC. Now you got to know what are the reasons: the abrogation of Article 370, then the pandemic, the China is in the bad books of international community. To divert its attention, what China has did, it has entered into a dispute with India, also in the South China Sea. The South China Sea I will be dealing in later. So just focus on the Galwan clash right now. Got it? So now you know the perception of LAC from both Indian side and the China side and what led to the clashes. So there is an agreement between India and China after the 1962 incident. A brief war was fought in 1962, which was the major flashpoint. This Galwan, the both armies met in the Galwan. They were a little skirmishes there. So this led to a brief war of 1962 where the India lost the war and Aksai Chin was taken by China. Right. So now let me see the way forward. What is the way forward? So before the incident took place, after the 1962 war, there was not a single incident reported from both either sides. Why? Because of the various agreements that has been signed between India and China that restricts the use of firepower or arms and ammunitions when the soldiers meet at the gray areas, the gray zones. What are gray zones? Gray zones are nothing but there is a difference in perception of LAC. So there is a buffer zone where both India and China can patrol. When there is a gray zone where both the soldiers can patrol, so their meeting is more frequent. So when they meet, there will obviously be some clashes. So to avoid the casualties, to avoid the loss of life, India and China has entered into many agreements to avoid casualty of life. Let me speak about those agreements in brief, so it will help you in writing the examination in more clear way. Got it? So what are the agreements that bind India and China so as to not to use the force in the LAC? If both armies encounter or confront each other, both soldiers of both the nations confront each other, what will happen? So that no casualty is caused, there are various agreements between India and China. So to name few of them, the 1993 Agreement on Peace and Tranquility. So there was again an agreement signed in 2005. In 2005, another agreement was signed between India and China regarding the same to not to use the force. Use of force in the LAC is prohibited. Use of force in the sense use of arms, use of guns, so that there is no casualty on either side. But what it did? The Galwan clashes, the both the soldiers fought with clubs and the ancient weapons like sickle and all, and they killed each other. 20 casualties was reported on the Indian side, and the number of casualty on the Chinese side is still unknown. There is no official communication from the Chinese side as to how many lives they lost. Got it? So if there is a perception, if there is a border issue between both the nations, then they cannot progress together. India and China are large neighbors. They are what you call a Asian century. They are the leading horses of the Asian century. If you take the size of economy, if you take the size of geographical extent of both the countries, if you take the armies of both the countries, they are very large. Even if the population, we are number 192 in the world. Given all that, we should be friendly neighbors. We should avoid all the confrontations. So why the clash, where the clash, what are the reasons for the clash, and the difference in perception of LAC, what is LAC? Since there is an ambiguity in the perception, there is the clash. So what must be the way forward? So I have said about the Asian century, the leading horses, the horses to win the race are India and China. I said the reasons why is the Asian century belonging to India and China. Why does the Asian century belong to India and China? Got it? So there must be a way forward. There must be a dispute resolution process where this is resolved amicably, so that no further disputes erupt and we are cordial to each other, and our economic ties and culture, our economic ties progresses. So this is the Galwan area in the Pangong So Lake. As I said, it's a very resource rich lake. It also helps in the blue water economy. If you see here, they can be divided into many fingers. Fingers means the mountains and valleys. They constitute finger areas here. So if you see here, from F1, finger 1 to finger 8 is the region of the Pangong So Lake. If you observe Pangong So Lake, it is a 134 kilometer long lake. Where does it originate? It originates in the Tibet region, Tibet Autonomous Region of China, and only a small part. The small part is in the Indian side. The majority of water, the source or origin of the water, and the majority of the extent of the lake lies in the Chinese territory. So here, what lies in the, if you see here, this is the LAC. Both are LAC. I said there is a difference in perception of LAC. If you look at here, the yellow line represents the China's perception of LAC, and the red line represents the Indian perception of LAC. So the Indian perception of LAC in the Pangong So Lake region is until finger 8 area, until the mountain of finger 8. So the China, how China sees this LAC? China's claim is up to the finger 2 area. It's between finger 2 and finger 3. If you notice here, in the finger 4 area, India has got a base, a military base. That means up to finger 4 area, it is administered by India. So back then, many decades earlier, what India used to do? India used to patrol, because this was the gray area. There is ambiguity in the perception. So the gray area, both the soldiers of both the nations are allowed to patrol this area. If they patrol this area, there will obviously they meet at each other at some point of time, right? So when they meet each other, they will argue that this belongs to China, and Indian side says this belongs to India. So the dispute, okay? So what has China did after the clash? China has cut off all the links. So India can only patrol up to F4, the finger 4 area. Traditionally, India used to patrol up till finger 8 area. Now after the clashes, what has China did? China has said that the Chinese LAC lies beyond the confluence of the Shouka and Galwan River, and in the Pangong So area where the LAC goes, China says it lays claim up to finger 2. This is all about the Pangong So region. So 134 kilometer long stretch, majority of lies in the Chinese side of LAC. Got it? So now let me speak about the way forward. So what should be the dispute resolution process between the nations so as to progress together, so as to realize the dream of Asian century? A comprehensive strategy needs to be evolved. Okay, so to diffuse and dissolve the situation that exists in the Galwan, now there is heavy military mobilization from both the sides. Okay, to restrict that and to limit that, what has both the sides done? Both the sides have met on the lines of corps commander level. They have been involved in talking. Both the corps commander of the Indian side and the corps commander of the Chinese side, they are involved in talking. There are 9 rounds of talk that has happened, still no solution. So when 2007 Doklam issue happened, the Prime Minister Modi and his counterpart Xi Jinping, the President of China, met on the lines of SCO. SCO meaning Shanghai Cooperation Organization. When both the leaders met, so the situation was dissolved. Okay, the dispute was resolved in the Doklam issue 2017, if you remember it. And the informal meeting that took place in Mamallapuram of Chennai and the Wuhan in China. Wuhan is the place of where the coronavirus originated, right? So both leaders on the informal meet, they met on the informal lines in Mamallapuram in Chennai and Wuhan in China. So it resulted in the dissolution of the dispute. Okay, the resolution of the dispute. So comprehensive strategy, so what the tactical strategy may be carried forward by the military. So all the talking should be done by the political leadership, or the diplomatic channel should be kept open. So if diplomacy is involved, diplomats are very well versed with the situation. The military doesn't know the civilian language. They are built to win the wars, so their mindset is different. When both army commanders meet, they want a win-win situation, or a win to their side and lose to the other side. Win to their side and lost to the other side. So when diplomats or the political leadership of the countries meet, they have the larger idea of and the larger picture. So the dispute can be resolved amicably. So a comprehensive strategy needs to be carved out here. So clarification on LAC. So all the disputes that are between the border disputes that are between India and China is because of the difference in perception, how the Chinese view where the LAC exists and how the India views where the LAC exists. So both the leadership must sit on the table and they should discuss this in detail, and the border must be demarcated for realizing the Asian century. Okay, so the LAC needs to be clarified here. So scaling down of military contact. So what do you mean by scaling down of military contact? Both the militaries on the lines of mutual exercises, and when they are patrolling the gray area, their face off should be minimized. So the military mobilization which has taken place, the heavy military mobilization should be reduced. So the military contact must be scaled down, and the diplomatic or the political contact must be increased. Got it? So counterbalance for outside world. You know, India is the largest democracy. United States is the oldest democracy. So we are a democratic nation. We must adhere to the democratic values. So we are increasingly, though we are in NAM, non-aligned movement, we were the leader of NAM. Now in the recent years, we have increasingly tilted towards the United States. So we can soft power of democracy to gain international recognition and to solve this dispute amicably. Got it? This is all about the Galwan issue. In the next class, let us see about the Indo-Nepal issue, about Limpiadura, Lipun Lake and Kalapani area. Thank you, one and all.
Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell button for latest educational videos.